I was interested in the Arctic for many years already, and I also was working for other projects in the Arctic. But I always wanted to create a project which is dealing with the Arctic as a whole. And that needed some years. It needed to grow. The Polar Silk Road project deals with the current developments around the North Pole regarding economy, but also these geopolitical tensions between the Arctic and neighboring states. My personal aim is to transport those developments also for outsiders, to open an access to this very often unknown and invisible places. The most important first step is the definition of the idea, what is the aim of the project. And once this is fixed, I can start with the concrete research and then afterwards with the organization of the project. It's also very important for me to get an idea of the space itself. So I need pictures, I need, well, general information, I need maps to get an idea about the dimension of the space and to get an idea how much time I would need to create a convincing portrait of this particular place. And these phases of research and organization, they need months, sometimes years. For the Polar Silk Road, it cost me about 5 years of research and organization. And you have to be open to invest this time, otherwise you will not succeed. Well, working in the Arctic is pretty challenging. On the one hand for the technique, on the other hand for me as a photographer. It's mentally and physically challenging. The lowest temperatures have been minus 55 degrees Celsius, so I can protect myself with special polar clothes. And another advantage is the mechanical camera itself. So I'm working with an analog view camera, and that enables me to stay outside longer than working with batteries, for instance. And the personal approach as a photographer to my photographs is that I take only one picture per motif. So that makes it risky. On the one hand, I have to take care of my material. I don't have endless material with me. And on the other hand, it increases my perception, my consciousness. So for me personally, it's very important first to approach the space, to get an impression about the space itself, and to select the pictures directly when I'm there on the location. So I can prepare all the projects pretty well in advance, but of course I always have to be flexible. The weather is changing very quickly, you have to deal with whiteout situations, you have to deal with the hostile landscape, with very strong winds, so you have to be in a good condition from the physical point of view as well. Very often the working process is very, very lonely, and you have to fight with this loneliness too, which, well, can make you crazy after a while. But on the other hand, for me personally, the working condition is also it's exciting. It's like an adventure because you're really exposed to the power of nature. I never wanted to realize a project about the climate change, but soon, of course, recognized that this climate change or the global warming is the main motor of all these developments around the North Pole. There are environmental changes happening there, and I experienced some of them myself when I was working there, or heard things from the people living there. Above all, we have the rising sea level, and this causes erosion along the coasts. As well, winds are getting stronger and stronger, and that together in combination with the rising sea level lets complete villages disappear along the coast. I want the people to become more aware about this general topic, dealing with the Arctic and also the Antarctic. Because most of the people only know that there's somewhere melting ice and that's it. I want to cause a discussion which is going more into the depth of the topic. Very often I experience things and see things which make me think I'm pretty pessimistic. On the one hand, I'm fascinated by those landscapes, I'm very impressed and have lots of respect, and on the other hand, I'm scared. Because I see what is going on there and what is happening there.